Welcome to the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where lives are being supernaturally changed and transformed by the liberating power of God's Word. His ministry is on the cutting edge, helping people around the world to discover, to develop, and to deploy their God-given potential. As you listen to him today, your life will be radically changed and never the same again. Listen and be blessed, for your change has come.
That is not natural. Jesus walking on the sea is not natural. There are natural behavior. And there are supernatural behavior.
You cannot truly rise in life if you don't know how to see challenges and decide your faith in the midst of challenges. That's how you know great people.
I said, always use God's promises to do what? To confront any situation in your life. No matter what the situation looks like right now, the promises of God is greater than the situation.
Here is your teacher, Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Stay tuned.
Results, that's what we're looking at this morning. Strong faith, great results. There is no impossibility for those who step out by faith. And no opposition can contend with a strong faith. And there are pictures of people who decided to have a new destiny as a result of their faith in God. Jesus said something. He said, have faith in God. Because there is faith in people, there is faith in job, there is faith in what you can do, but Jesus said, have faith in God. Because faith in God cannot fail. This is the kind of faith that always wins, the faith in God. Jesus said, have faith in God. He never said, have faith in the job. He never said, have faith in what you can do for yourself. He said, have faith in God. Because faith in God will produce results, and faith in God will receive everything that Jesus did in the finished work. Faith in God. And when people's faith is in God and not in what they can do, they do the extraordinary. Because faith in God will achieve extraordinary results. Faith in God can look at cancer and say it's over. Faith in God can look at HIV and say it's over. Faith in God can look at infection and say die to the roots. Faith in God can look at debt and say pay in full. Faith in God can look at poverty and say this is the end of it.
Amen.
Faith in God can look at joblessness, then a multi-billion-dollar idea arrived to create an organization that will employ labor. Faith in God will produce results. And because God is at work, anything is possible. There are pictures of people who decided to take their destiny by faith. Then I'm going to show you those pictures this morning. Mark chapter 2. In Mark chapter 2, verse 1, hallelujah, it said, and again he entered into Capernaum, and after some days, a noise that he was in the house. Oh my God, Jesus was in the house. It was noise that he was in the house. If the word of God is in your house, it means there's going to be a sound of celebration.
Amen.
There's going to be a sound of victory. There's going to be a sound. It was noise that he was in the house. People heard that Jesus was in town. They heard that Jesus was around. Verse 2 said, and straight away many were gathered together. We are gathered together in so much that there was no room to receive them, not so much as a bound dog, and he preached the word unto them. I like Jesus because he preaches the word. Strong faith, great result. Faith in God means God at work. I said what? Faith in God means what? God at work. It doesn't matter what you're going through right now, financially, emotionally, or spiritually, faith in God can rescue, faith in God can salvage, faith in God can produce. And he said something here that was so important. He said he preached the word. Why did Jesus preach the word? If there was going to be a transformation, it will come by revelation. If there was going to be a transformation in the lives of people, that it was going to come forth by revelation. Mark chapter 2. And he said, and Jesus preached the word. He preached the word. And whenever the word goes forth, healing goes forth. Whenever the word goes forth, miracle is going forth. Whenever the word goes forth, signs and wonders is going forth. Whenever the word goes forth, restoration is going forth. That was why he said in Psalm 107, he sent forth the word. So when the word goes forth, expectations begin to come into manifestation.
Hallelujah.
When the word goes forth, expectation begins to come into manifestation. Let me say this to you. It doesn't matter where you are, you can rise above it.
Yes, sir.
You can rise above it. In verse 3, Mark chapter 2, verse 3, and there come unto him, bringing one of the sick of the palsy, which was bore of four. And when they could not near, when they could not near unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was. And when he has broken it, and when they have broken it up, they let down wherein he that was sick, the sick of the past, lay. They lay him down. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick that had passed, he said, son, thy sin be forgiven of thee. Jesus saw their faith. That simply means faith is visible. Faith can be recognized. A man who is broke, that made the word of God the foundation of his life, can rise into life of abundance. A man who is broke, no job, no nothing, and he said, God, I mean business with you. I'm going to stay with your word. I'm going to be committed to serving you. I'm going to be committed to the kingdom. Watch them. I said, watch them. Before you realize things will begin to shift, unknown to most people, they are carrying an atmosphere. And whatever that is in you determines the atmosphere you carry. Whatever that is in you determines the atmosphere you carry. And these guys carried their friend that was paralyzed. And they didn't wait for Jesus to say, why is your tongue to be healed? They didn't do that. The guys know what they wanted. Strong faith break the roof. They didn't wait for Jesus to say, I have a word of knowledge. Someone there have paralysis, be healed. They were not waiting for that. They were not waiting for word of knowledge. Their faith was taking it.
Hallelujah.
They were not waiting for word of knowledge. There is someone here that God is about to heal. No. These guys don't understand word of knowledge. These guys understand your faith takes it.
Yeah.
So you know what they did? They went to that roof and uncovered it. Then they let this guy down, and the Bible said, and Jesus saw their faith. Strong faith moves when others stop.
Mm-hmm.
Strong faith continues when others quit. And you know what happened? Because their faith was ready, it got God's attention. There is another guy again that I want to show you. Let me show you this woman. What happened? Mark chapter 5. Strong faith does not bow to challenges. In Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5, let's read from verse 25. Look at this. Mark 5, verse 25. He said something very important. He said, and a certain woman which had an issue of blood for 12 years have suffered many things of many physicians and have spent all that she had and was nothing better but rather grievous. When she heard of Jesus, this is how it starts. This is how your problems begin to go away. This is how you begin to solve your problem. When he heard of Jesus. So strong faith comes by hearing about Jesus. Strong faith comes by hearing about what Jesus has done in the past, what Jesus is doing in the present, and what Jesus is going to do in the future. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Jesus is the same. If he has healed before, he wants to heal again. If he has delivered before, he wants to deliver again. That was why we had that same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. If it dwells in you, it will quicken. And this woman heard about Jesus, then she said, if I can touch. If I can touch, I will be made whole. So her healing started with her setting her conversation in the right direction. She started declaring her healing. If I can touch, you know, faith in God sees the picture of the victory. Faith in God goes into the future and it takes the picture of victory, then enforce it on the situation. That is what it does. Faith in God. So strong faith is a reliable faith. A faith that is reliable. Maybe you didn't have the money. And the 12 person is going for these millions of dollars or this amount of money. Now you tell them, no problem. I trust God. I believe God. I know God is going to make a way. There is something about those who have strong faith. They don't see oppositions as storm. They see it as a pathway. You know why? Their faith can pay for anything.
Yeah.
I said what? Their faith can pay for anything. What God is waiting for is your yes. If you can say yes, something is going to happen. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 11 and see how people did amazing things because their faith was in God. Look at Hebrews chapter 11. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 11. Let's read verse 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Faith is the substance. What is faith? Faith is the substance. How many of you know that faith is the resources? How you're building a business, you realize that one of the resources you need is faith. And it is faith in God, because faith in God will keep moving even when the picture is not clear, because faith functions from God's perspective. Faith in God will keep moving even when the picture is not clear. If you're going to walk with the Holy Ghost, it's going to be by faith. I said, if you're going to walk with the Holy Ghost, it's going to be by what? It's going to be by faith. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good report. So, strong faith is a good report producer. I said, what? Strong faith is a good report producer. It will produce good results. It will produce good results. And this is why we'll keep listening to God's word. We'll keep taking the word of God into our spirit. And John 15 verse 3 said, ye are cleansed by the word. Ye are cleansed by the word. God's word brings the cleansing. God's word comes with God's energy. I said, God's word comes with God's energy. And the presence of God's word guarantee the ability of God at work. I said, the presence of God's word guarantees the ability of God at work. That was why he said in Psalm 107, he sent forth his word. Why? Because that word contains the ability of God. So when the word arrived, it was God that had arrived. John Gospel, John chapter 1, verse 1. It said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word. Look at Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. And the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. The next thing was heard, and God spoke. And God said, when God said, he, the words that came out of him carried a creative ability. It was that word that manufactured, that created that light. Strong faith maintained a strong confession towards God's word. Strong faith will do what? It will maintain a strong confession. He said, for by in the earnest obtain a good report. Verse 3 said, through faith we understand. How are we going to understand? How are you going to understand the things of the Spirit?
Through faith.
How will you understand that this debt is paid?
Through faith.
How will you understand that you never be broke another day?
Through faith.
How will you understand that life is moving in your favor?
Through faith.
How will you understand that, well, this year is going to be the year of my marriage?
Through faith.
How will you understand that this year there's going to be a supernatural restoration?
Through faith.
How will you understand that you're buying your car this season? Come on.
Through
faith. How will you understand that all things are possible?
Through faith.
He said, through faith we understand. So there's an understanding that will gain through faith. An understanding. He said, through faith we understand. Through faith, I understand that the depression is over. Through faith, I understand that I will not continue in this situation. Through faith, I understand that the money is coming. Through faith, I see the overflow. Come on. Through faith, I believe that God has done it already. Through faith, I see the perfect picture of my future. Through faith, I see lives changing around the world. Through faith, I see that I'm debt free. Come on, somebody, this morning, you got to see. He said, through faith, we understand. Through faith, I understand that this storm has passed away. Through faith, I understand that this many days to end this year is going to be the best days of my life this year. Through faith, I understand that all things will work together for good. Through faith, I understand that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Through faith, I understand that economic recession is not for me. Through faith, I understand that the famine in the land is not for me. Through faith, I understand that the promises of God is available for me. Through faith, I understand that the finished work of Jesus is all I need to stand on to enforce my destiny. Through faith, I understand. Wow. That's what they said. That's what these guys said. They said, through faith. Through faith, we understand. Not through sight. Not through statistic. Not through analysis. Come on, somebody, talk to me this morning. Not through scientific research. Come on, somebody. Come, somebody's trying to understand through scientific research. No, no, no. That's not even understanding. He said, through faith, you understand.
Hallelujah.
Well. I pray this man, this thing come into your spirit. I pray it just downloading your spirit. He said, through faith, you understand. So through faith, what do I do? I understand that this storm is over. This issue is over. Through faith, I understand. I understand. There's an understanding that comes with faith that strengthens your walk with God. There is an understanding that comes by faith that strengthens your walk with God. I understand that through faith, I understand that this problem is not forever. This situation is not forever. I understand. Faith quickens understanding. Faith quickens understanding. Through faith, I understand. I just want you to get this. Father, I pray that everyone watching this service live and those present here, that this word come into your spirit and impact you right now.
Amen.
Through faith, you understand that all things are possible. Through faith, you understand that you can go through it and comfort. Through faith, you understand that this thing is over. Through faith, you understand that this toiling season has ended.
Amen.
Through faith, you understand you're not coming back home empty today.
Amen.
Through faith, you understand that the money coming to you right now.
Amen.
Through faith, you understand that your testimony has started right now.
Amen.
Through faith, you understand that all things are possible to him that believe. Through faith, you understand. There is an understanding that comes from faith.
Hallelujah.
An understanding. Through faith, we understand. Through faith, you understand. Wow. I've been reading that scripture for many years. I haven't seen it. Till I saw it. Through faith, we understand.
Hallelujah.
This is why it says Psalm 19, verse 2, day unto day that God uttered speech. That day unto day. This is why why you need to stay and keep hearing the word of God. He said, through faith, we understand. We understand that the world was framed by the word of God. Wow. Wow. That through faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God. So you can frame your future by the word of God. Through faith, you can frame your finances. Come on. Through faith, you can frame, you can create something. Through faith, you can make this thing to happen. Wow. Through faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God. Wow. So it is by the word of God you take the healing. It is by the word of God you take the deliverance. Come on, someone, this morning, hearing me?
Yes.
By the word of God, you break the limitation. Through faith, we understand. You begin to say, I can pay that money. I can pay all that. And then you begin to maintain the right confession towards it. You begin to speak in the direction of God's way. Through faith, we understand. There is someone here this morning, and someone watching this broadcast live, and God is saying, if you understand it through faith, you can do it.
Amen.
If you can understand the true faith, you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. That house will be completed.
Amen.
I said that house will be completed. Through faith, I understand that you're paying it off this season.
Amen.
And look at what he said here again. Let's look at it. Hebrews 11, verse 3 said, through faith we understand that the world was framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of the things which do appear. The things that are seen were not made by the things that what?
Appear.
That do appear. Oh my God. Oh my God. We are stepping into this thing deeper right now. That means everything that I've seen came by the word. The word. You don't see the word, but you speak the word. You can't hold it and just say, this is the word. But you speak the word. It's a true faith to understand. And look at what it said in verse 12. By faith, Abel offered unto God more excellent sacrifice. By faith. Not that he had everything. Not that Abel had everything, but it came by faith. An excellent sacrifice was because of faith. Ha, ha, ha. Look at this. It said, by faith, Abel offered an excellent sacrifice. And there is someone watching this morning, and the Lord said, it's your season to offer an excellent sacrifice by faith.
Yeah, amen.
By faith he offered an excellent sacrifice. He didn't have everything that others had, but he knew how to use his faith to give God the best. So we can't truly give the best except by faith. We can't truly give the best. This man here shifted the cloud. Let's look at the next scripture. Verse 5 said, by faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death. By faith. By faith. By faith. Let's look at the next verse. I'm just taking part of it. Hebrews 11, verse 6. But without faith, it's impossible to please him. So, without faith, it's impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe.
Must,
not yes.
Must.
Not emotion. He that cometh to God, must. If you're coming to God, what is the requirement?
You must believe. Hallelujah.
You must believe. You must do what? You must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Verse 7. By faith, Noah being warned of God of the things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared the ark to the saving of his house.
Hallelujah.
Wow.
By faith.
By faith, this guy started building. Come on. By faith, someone start building your dreams and your destiny.
By faith.
The next verse, verse 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into the place which he should enter, he has received for inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whether he went.
Ooh, by faith. Hallelujah.
Okay, verse 9. By faith, he sojourned in the land of the promise. Hey.
By faith.
You know, this scripture my friend shared it with me many years ago, and it came to pass. He said, Abraham came to that land by faith. He sojourned in the land of promise.
By faith.
By faith. As a strange country, dwelling in a tabernacle with Isaac and Jacob, the heir with him of the same promise. Verse 10, for he looked for a city which had foundation, and whose builder and maker is God.
God by faith. By Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
By faith. Verse 11 said, through faith, Sarah. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you know Mrs. Sarah.
Yes.
By faith.
Hallelujah.
By faith. Sarah also had come up by faith. Everybody's showing up. Everybody in Hebrews 11, we are people that do something by faith.
Yeah.
If you never made it by faith, Hebrew 11 will record you. Hebrew 11 is where people who broke limitation, who changed history, who impacted the world, they came to register their name. By faith, Sarah. This Sarah, someone gonna say, look at this barren woman. Sarah broke the limitation by faith. I take more one verse, I'm undone. Glory be to God. Okay, let me do verse 23, Hebrews 11, 23. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid for 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child, and then being not afraid of the king's commandments.
By faith.
The next verse, by faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. You understand his destiny. By faith. By faith, he walked away from a place that looks like pleasure because he was not consistent with God's will for his life. It was by faith. You break up from ungodly time. You break up from ungodly relationship by what?
By faith.
You walk out and say, God is my source. He's going to provide for me.
By faith.
Let's rise to our faith this morning. Let's give a praise. It's by faith this morning. Oh, it's by faith this morning. By faith, you're going to build a house. By faith, you're going to receive. By faith, you'll be healed. By faith, you'll be delivered. By faith, you'll begin to pursue your dream and your vision. By faith, come on. Everyone that received was by faith. You believe, you receive. My name is Sakandere Mosakarim Baba. Reko Tolimbra Kababa. Rekam Ladeska Talambro Doske Tolimbra Kababa. Reka Pandeska Talimbra Deska Talambaba. Thank you, Father. By faith, we lay hold. By faith, we see opportunity and possibilities. By faith, we see all things working for our good. By faith. If you're watching this broadcast this morning and you have not known Jesus as your Lord and Savior, or you're at this service, and the best thing you can do with your life is to know Jesus. If you want to give your life to Christ, you want to be born again, You can just repeat this prayer with me right now. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with us, you're born again and you will never remain the same. We love you. Until our next broadcast, don't forget that Jesus is Lord.